Hello. Today we are going to talk about the material that we call masonry. Okay, and actually the masonry has very, very long history in the construction world. Okay, in the Egyptian era, okay, or when we go and have a look in the construction of the Egypt people, okay, at that time. Okay, that is like 5,000 years ago. Okay, at that time, 5,000 years ago, okay, we can observe that human being or the people, okay, already learned to make the type of the material that coming as the block. Okay, and that can consider as the first time that human being learned to make a type of the brick. Okay, but that at that time, the brick made from a mud. Okay, and they just lay the brick together, okay, at that time. Okay, after that, in the Greece, okay, in the Greek era, okay, we learn more. Okay, we found that the ancient Greek people, okay, learn that if they take the clay, okay, and burn it at some temperature, okay, they can have a lead product like this, okay, and they call this the clay tile, okay. And normally, if you go to the ancient city in this zone, okay, you will see that there is a lot of ancient structure that make with the lead, okay, loop tile, okay, lead loop tile, okay. This is probably the first clay product. Okay, that is used. Okay, and this is the product that is quite similar to the today brick for the construction that we are now using. Okay, but at that time the Greek people, okay, use this brick for the roof. So it's not intend to resist any force at that time. Alright, but after that, when we go into the Roman Empire, okay, if you go to the Roman Empire now, we will start to see. Okay, the Roman Empire to use the brick as the component of the structure. Okay, so it means that we can see that the Roman people, okay, in different way, okay, don't use the brick for only the roof anymore. Okay, in the Greek era, you will see that the structure itself, the part that it will need to resist the force, will made from rock. Okay, we made from rock and Roman cement. Okay, but for the Roman Empire, we will start to see that they use this brick, okay, the burned brick, okay, as the part of the structure, okay, and also the part of the pavement. Okay, we can also see the use of the brick, okay, in our Thai ancient kingdom, okay, like Sukhothai and Ayutthaya. Okay, and we would say that this is the brick and masonry is the main structural material in our cultural heritage structures. Okay, so we should make the understanding about the masonry and what it is. Okay, but we need to make it clear that masonry is not the type of the brick. Okay, but the word masonry is actually the name of the structural system. Okay, or the construction materials that composed with one or two component. Okay, normally it will compose of two. Okay, the first one will be the solid material as a block. Okay, that is sometimes called a brick. Okay, so brick is the first component of the masonry. And normally you will need a type of the mortar, okay, or type of the material that you will fill in between the brick. Okay, so for the lead brick that we are using nowadays, normally we will use the cement mortar and lay. Okay, all right. The brick itself may be this lead brick, or it can be the concrete masonry brick, or it can be the lightweight concrete block. Okay, with this becoming more popular in the last 3 decades. Okay, I will talk about this in detail later. Okay, but actually there are some other type of the masonry. Okay, that there is no material filling the gap between the material at all. Okay, for example, we may construct the masonry by using the stone, laying it on top of each other, and you don't put any mortar in between. Okay, this type is actually considered a masonry as well. Alright, but there is no mortar inside. Okay, or we may use the interlocking brick wall. It means that we make the brick into the shape that is locked to each other. Okay, and normally in this case, we also don't use the mortar in between the brick. Okay, so in general, okay, we will expect that masonry composed of brick itself, okay, and the material that fill the gap between the brick. Okay, but there are some special case that we have the masonry, but there is no filling material as well. Okay, please keep this in your mind. All right. The first type of the brick, okay, that you need to know is the lead brick or the clay brick. Okay, actually this clay brick, okay, is not making from the clay and put in the natural environment, but in order to make this brick, normally you will need to select the appropriate clay or soil, okay, and then you put into the shape that you want, okay, and then you need to burn it, okay, and the burning normally take the high temperature like 1300 degrees Celsius, okay. After that you will get, okay, the clay from the dark color, okay, will change into the red color. Okay, and after you wait until it's cool down, then it will be ready for the construction. Okay, the density of this one is normally in the range of 1600 to 1900 kilogram per cubic meters. Okay, this number is a little bit lower than the density of the concrete itself that we use nowadays. Okay, but the compressive strength of this one is also normally lower than the normal concrete. Okay, and actually I would say that the variation of the compressive strength is very high, very high. So if you want to use this brick to resist the load, okay, you must be aware of this point. Okay, the absorption of this brick is quite high. Okay, it has been reported that this type of brick can absorb, okay, from 10 okay, to 25 of its own dry weight. Okay, that value is quite high for the construction materials. Okay, but it also have considerable thermal conductivity. Okay, after this, okay, after we use the clay brick, actually the clay brick has been popular, okay, in the last century. Okay, before we have more and more cement product. Okay, that made from the modern Portland cement. Okay, in the last probably 5 or 6 decades, okay, in Thailand we had type of the product made from the Portland cement, okay, which mixed with the aggregate, okay, put in the blocks and then compress it. Okay, so this type of the block, okay, is called the concrete masonry block. Okay, and in order to produce this type of the block, actually you don't need to heat it. You don't need to heat it. Okay, what you will need to do is that you take the aggregate with the appropriate size, okay, and take the cement, okay, and mix it, okay, adding some water in, okay, and then you put this into some block or formwork and compress it. Okay, after that you can just wait until it gain the strength. Okay, this type of the concrete masonry block is also popular in Thailand. Okay, the weight of the material itself is slightly lower than the clay brick or the lead brick that I showed in the previous slide. Okay, but the compressive strength is lower. Okay, the important things of this material is that if you compare the thermal conductivity of this concrete masonry block, okay, with the lead brick, you will see that this one has very low thermal conductivity. And the low thermal conductivity means that means that this one can insulate your structure, so it keep the temperature in your rooms. Okay, so if you use the air condition, this one can keep the temperature, okay, better than the lead brick, okay, the clay brick, okay, and this means that it is saving more energy, okay, all right. There is another type of the block as well nowadays, okay. This is popular in the rural area, okay. The color is also lead, but it is not the clay brick, okay. It is called interlocking block, okay, and the production of this interlocking block is different from the lead brick or the clay brick, okay. The interlocking block, which have also lead color, is normally produced from cement, okay, and the lead soil, okay, or laterite soil, okay, and mix. So the production is in similar manner with the concrete block I showed in the previous slide. Okay, you don't need to heat it up at high temperature. Okay, but you just use the lead aggregate or lead soil as the component. And because you use the lead soil as the component, normally you will be able to compress it. Okay, and gain very high density of this brick. Okay, and when you get high density, of course you will get slightly higher compressive strength of the materials. Okay, and in the production of this type of the brick, okay, normally we will decide the shape of the interlocking part, okay, so you can put the block together, okay, without adding any wall filling materials like mortar, okay. If you are not confident about the stability in the case that you don't put the mortar, okay, we have option that probably we can sometimes you put the rebar in, or you may put some material inside as well if you want to. Okay, but normally that is not required in the general case. Okay, the thermoconductivity of this material is also very low. Okay, similar to the case of the concrete block. Okay, In the construction of this masonry, it means that you are now trying to take any type of brick. Okay, it can be the clay or lead brick. Okay, it can be the concrete block. Okay, and it can be interlocking block, and you want to make it layer by layer up to each other. Okay, and I show you some traditional method. Okay, normally you will need to lay this brick one by one. And you will see that normally we will not put the brick on the same position, but we will just overlap it layer by layer. Okay, this is to enhance, okay, or to make sure that each block of the brick will work together as the integral part. Okay, if you put the brick at the same location in our layer, sometimes you will have weak line. Okay, that is not favorable in the case of the construction. Okay, in this case of the concrete block, you will see as well that we put it in similar manner. Okay, this is the first thing that you must notice when we do the brick laying works. Okay, second thing you must alert that when you put the concrete laying, okay, the mortar itself will get hardened, and during the hardening process of the mortar, okay, the wall may come down a little bit. Okay, so normally we will put the brick laying layer, okay, and left some space on top, and then we wait, okay, for some period of time, like 2 days or 3 days, okay, until the lower part get hardened or become hardened and gain the strength, okay, then we will fill the top layer, okay, at the end. Okay, this is the construction techniques. Okay, also At some region that we feel that the material may be weak, like a joint between the wall itself with the columns, okay, or the corner when you lay the brick and you have a kind of the corner, okay, we may also intentionally put some steel bar, okay, at that location in order to make sure that part, okay, will be able to hold each other, okay, better or become stronger. Alright, so this is the technique that you may apply, okay, and it will help. Alright, Okay, in the modern construction, however, okay, the lead brick, okay, the concrete block, okay, or interlocking block is not the most popular choice, especially in the construction of the modern houses or the high-rise building like a condominiums. Okay, but actually we have another product, okay, called lightweight concrete block. Okay, so if you go to this, you will see, if you go to the construction product store, okay, you will see that there is a type of the concrete block that has no holes, okay, but the weight is really light. That is actually special type of the concrete, okay, made from the Portland cement, okay, with water, okay, and we add some foaming agent, and normally there are two broad category of the foaming techniques. Okay, foaming means we are creating air bubble inside the cement paste. Okay, so in the production of this lightweight concrete block, okay, which is different from the previous concrete block. Okay, previous concrete block will contain aggregate. Okay, put the cement with aggregate and then you compress in the block. Okay, but this one you will have just cement water. Okay, sometimes you will add slightly sand, but you will not have the log or coarse aggregate at all. Alright, but you have in this case is that you add some foaming agent, and the function of the foaming agent is that to create air bubble, okay, in the body of the cement paste. Okay, and when you create the air bubble in the body of the cement paste, you make the weight of this concrete very, very low. Alright, and the first technique that we can use is that we put some foam. Okay, you use some chemical and then you add water and then you try to make it as a foam. Okay, the type of the foam will be just similar to the foam that you get when you make the showering. Okay, but of course the chemical formula is different. Okay, in this case we will use the chemical substance that is more stable in foaming. Okay, if you add that type of foam, okay, into the cement paste during the mixing, okay, we will call this type of the concrete that is the product, okay, as the cellular lightweight concrete, okay, or CLC. Okay, so if we use the word CLC, we are referring that we make the lightweight concrete block by adding some foam during the mixing. Alright, the second type, okay, of this production is that you add some aluminum powder during the mixing. Okay, and after you finish mixing, then you put this material at high temperature. Okay, the temperature is normally 180 degrees Celsius with the pressure of 800 kilopascal. Okay, with this temperature, the aluminum powder will create the gas bubble. Okay, so during hardening process, okay, you will find that your concrete, okay, will create the bubble and the volume will increase a lot. Okay, this process is the type of the production that we call autoclave aerated concrete production. Okay, and this concrete is sometimes called AAC. AAC. Okay, so if you have the lightweight concrete block, okay, you must be able to identify that there are two different type, okay, CLC and AAC. Okay, due to its production, okay, CLC can be made in the factory, okay, and it can be also made on the construction site as well. Because you can just put the foaming agent in the mixer and then cast it. Alright, but for AAC, okay, since you will need to keep it at high temperature, okay, it's a kind that you will need to bake it for a certain period of time. Just a similar case to the making a bread. Okay, a bread. Normally we will just be able to create the AAC in the factory. Okay. But the good thing of AAC is that the AAC, since you keep it at high temperature, normally it will become solid and gain the strength in very very rapid rate. Okay, so it means that after a few days, then you will be able to use this for the bricklaying work already. All right. Okay. So when you use the lightweight concrete block, normally we will not use the traditional mortar. Okay. The density, you will see that if we compare the density of this lightweight concrete block with other concrete block that I explained earlier, you will see that the value of the density is very low. It's very low, okay? I would say that the density is less than water in general. Okay, and it has very low thermal conductivity. Okay, so it means that it can insulate your room, okay, or the building, okay, really, really well, okay. We can even, okay, cut the brick by sawing, okay, if you go to the construction. Okay, so this make the construction is really easy when compared with other brick. Okay, the brick itself will come with slightly larger size when compared with the other brick that I explained earlier, because the density is low. Okay, so it can make larger, and because each block is larger, then it will save time in the brick laying. Okay, but the caution is that you cannot use the traditional mortar in order to laying this brick. Okay, but normally we will use the special type of the mortar. Okay, in order to laying this brick together, it will be thinner, okay, and has more adhesion. Okay, so please be careful about this. Okay. In the brick laying, normally we will need to make sure that the wall that make of the brick is stable. So in the case that you are making the wall, okay, you may need to think about the location of what we call tie beam and columns. Okay, tie beam and tie columns. Okay, what is tie beam and what is tie column? Tie beam means that if you have very large area of the brick laying, okay, and you don't put any additional structural system in order in between, okay, that large panel of the brick or masonry may be really weak. Okay, you must keep in your mind that now the brick is the composite of two materials, the brick and the mortar. Okay, and the interface between this is quite weak. Okay, so if you have very large panel of this one, okay, in general it may become very, very weak. Okay, so because of that, okay, if you do the brick laying work, you may need to consider to add tie beam and tie column in order to ensure that our masonry wall have enough integrity, okay, have enough stability. Okay, normally it is the requirement that the tie beam or the height of one portion of the brick laying should not be higher than 3 meters. Okay, you cannot put the brick wall and then put it like a 4 meter, 5 meter, 6 meter continuously. Okay, in that case it will become less and less stable, okay, and dangerous. So normally we will limit the height of one panel to 3 meters. Okay, and the width, okay, and the width normally it will be limited to 6 meters. Okay, in the case of low seismic leaks. Okay, it means if you have low chance or low risk of the earthquake load, okay, you can make it 6 meter width. But if you have higher chance, if you construct your masonry wall in the area with some seismic risk, okay, you may need to reduce this to 4.5. All right. Another point is at the opening, like a door or windows. Okay, normally we will need to provide the confining element, just look like the tie beam and column. Okay, allow the opening, allow the door, and allow the windows. Okay, and normally the tie beam and the tie column is made from concrete. Okay, with the size of approximately 10 centimeters, okay, or similar shape to the brick. Okay, but it has to be sufficiently thick, okay, in order to make the brick wall stable. Okay, this is the example of the tie beam and tie column. Okay, this tie beam and the tie column is actually add. Okay, we cannot make the masonry wall, okay, the whole as the one column because it will become quite weak. Alright, so we intentionally put this one, okay, and this one, okay, in order to keep the masonry panel, okay, stable. Okay, you will be able to see that we intentionally put some additional element, okay, allow the opening, okay. We will not put the brick as the element allow the opening. Okay, this is to prevent the problem. Okay, when there is some deformation, okay, of the wall itself. Okay, sometimes you may want, okay, to prevent the crack that may occur from the opening. In that case, we will put a type of the wire mesh. Okay, like this. Okay, when you do the construction, there is really high risk that you have the crack, okay? You got the crack, okay? Allow the corner of the opening or at the connection between the tie bar or tie beam or tie column with the masonry wall. In those cases, we will use these wires in order to prevent that cracking. All right, you just put these wires, okay? At the location of high crack risk, okay, cracking risk, okay, and then you just make the plastering, okay. After you construct the masonry wall, normally you will do the plastering in order to make the appearance of this wall smooth, okay. We will put this wire mesh before we put that plastering mortar, all right, okay. As the masonry wall is weak, okay, when compared with concrete or steel, okay, normally in general cases, okay, we will not consider masonry as the structural system. It means that we will not consider that masonry resists the force, okay. But in some cases, in some special cases, you may want the masonry to help, okay, to help resisting some load, especially the lateral load, or coming from wind load or seismic load. Okay, we found that the masonry wall will contribute, okay, to the resistance of this type of the load. Okay, and we can consider that. Okay, but this is not in the scope of this subject. Okay, so I will not explain in the details. Okay, when you study more. Okay, you will learn that the design of the brick, okay, may contribute to the structural behavior of this panel. Okay, so if you study in higher level, okay, we may intentionally split the wall into two parts in different direction, and the behavior of this wall, okay, or its contribution in the load resistance, okay, will change based on the detail inside. Okay, all right, keep this in your mind, keep this in your mind, all right. Okay, and when we select the type of the wall, okay, when we use the masonry to create the wall, we will need to also think about its function. Okay, do you want it to carrying any load or not? Okay, do you want it to prevent any moisture penetration or not? Okay, do you want it to prevent some sound? Okay, or you want to use it as the acoustic insulation or not? Do you want it to keep the temperature or not? Okay, or do you want it to be as the fire panel to prevent in the case of fire accident or not? Okay, normally this is the additional consideration that we will need to consider when we select the construction materials, okay. And there is also a type of the wall that intentionally put the cavity or put the space inside. Okay, this type of the wall is called cavity wall. Okay, and it's quite popular in some region. Okay, in some region, this type of the cavity wall will improve the acoustic insulation and thermal insulation. All right, but the details, okay, must be carefully designed so that the stability of the wall can be obtained. Okay, normally we will need to put some tie component, okay, in order to link these two wall, okay, on both sides of the cavity together and make it stable. Okay, sometimes you may also want to fill this cavity with the insulators materials, okay, but this will be more costly than the first option. All right, so this is the overall aspect of the material that we call masonry. Okay, the masonry is created from brick, okay, and some space filling, the gap filling, okay, materials, okay, but sometimes, okay, you may have only the brick, okay, or the log, and then you put together, okay, that is also considered the masonry as well, okay, and you will see that from the ancient time, okay, from the Egyptian era until today, we have continuous evolution or development of the brick or the masonry unit production. Okay, nowadays we use the lightweight concrete block, okay, as the main component. All right, and we may need to also understand the details of the wall. Okay, you may not depend on only the materials, but you depend on the component of the wall itself. You may intentionally add the cavity inside in order to improve. Okay, that is your choice as the engineers. Okay, this will be the end of my lecture about the masonry. So thank you very much.